Exercise 4.3. In the last video, we have solved up to 8th problem. Now let's talk about 9th problem. In this problem, two water taps together can fill a tank in 3 by 8 hours. The tap of large diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one. Find the time in which each tap can separately fill the tank. In these type of questions, you have to calculate the amount of the tank filled in 1 hour. So that is very important. So then it is very easy for us to do. Now the condition is, let's consider the larger diameter, the larger pipe can fill in X hours. Then in 1 hour, it can fill 1 by X portion of the tank. So this is our supposition. Let larger pipe can fill in X hours. Therefore, in 1 hour, this can fill this much of portion of the tank. Smaller pipe can fill in X plus 10 hours. Why? Because it is the given condition. The tap of larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one. So X plus 10. Therefore, in 1 hour, the smaller diameter pipe can fill 1 by X plus 10th portion of the tank. The other information given in the problem is that both can operate together and fill the water in 9 and 3 by 8 hours. So in 1 hour, both the pipes together can fill 1 by X plus 1 by X plus 10. This should be the reciprocal of total number of hours. The total number of hours, it is 9 and 3 by 8. That is 75 by 8. So here it should be 8 by 75. So now what we have done, we have taken the smaller pipe in 1 hour, bigger pipe in 1 hour, and when they are operated together, the information is given that 75 by 8 hours it takes. That means in 1 hour, 8 by 75th of the water or the tank is filled. Now this is the equation, and we will frame quadratic equations and then we solve it. So what is the LCM here? X times X plus 10. Here it is XX get cancelled. X plus 10 will come here. And then here X plus 10, X plus 10 will be cancelled. X will be here, which is equal to 8 by 75. Now by doing cross multiplication, 75 times X plus 750 plus 75 times of X is equal to 8, this X into X, X square, so 8X square, 8 into X into 10, that is 80X. Now 8X square plus this 80X and this 150X comes to this place, it comes with a negative, plus 750, that is also with negative, is equal to 0. Now 8x square minus 70x minus 750 is equal to 0. Now it can be cancelled throughout by 2. So 4x square minus 35x minus 750 means 375. Now we have to solve this quadratic equation. So to solve this quadratic equation, either we can go for the formula method or the splitting the middle term. So now let us see, let's use formula method here. X is equal to minus b, that is minus of minus 35, plus or minus square root of 35 square, minus 35 square, that is 35 square only, minus 35 square minus 4 into a 4, and then it is c, that is minus 375. Then it becomes positive, whole by 2 into 4. So here 35 plus or minus 35 square is 1225. Plus 375 into 4, it is 1500. 1500 into 4, that is 6000. Whole divided by 8. Now here, this is 35 plus or minus, this will be 7225. The root for 7225 is nothing but 85, and this should be divided by 8. Now we will get two answers for it. One is 35 plus 85 by 8. Second one is 35 minus 85 by 8. But 35 minus 85 by 8 is a negative quantity. Therefore, as we are considering x is the part of the tank that is filled by the smaller pipe in 1 hour. So negative answer is discarded here. So you have to take the positive answer. The positive answer tells us 85 plus 35, which is 120. Therefore, x is equal to 120 by 8, which is giving us 15. So when x is equal to 15, that is the larger tank that can fill the tap in 15 hours. So therefore, smaller one will fill in 25 hours. So larger fills it in 15 hours, and smaller one, as it takes 10 hours more, it should be 25 hours. In this problem, the main idea that you have to calculate the portion that is filled in 1 hour, then we can do very easily from the given data. Now, let's see the next problem, which is 10th one. An express train takes 1 hour less than a passenger train to travel 132 kilometers between Mysore and Bangalore. If the average speed of the express train is 11 kilometers per hour, more than that of the passenger train, then find the average speed of the two trains. Let the average speed of passenger train B x, then express train must have x plus 11 kilometers per hour. Now in both the two cases, the distance is same. The time taken by the passenger train is 3 hours. Let the time taken by the passenger train be 3 hours. Then by express train, it should be T minus 1 because it moves faster and according to the problem, it takes 1 hour less than. Here you must understand the distance is constant. That is, x into t is equal to 132, which is also equal to x plus 11 into t minus 1. Okay, now when x into t is equal to 132, then from this equation I can write t is equal to 132 by x, and I can very well substitute in the second equation. Therefore, x plus 11, 132 by x minus 1. I am substituting for this t as 132 by x. That is all equal to 132. Now what we can do, we simply take this LCM and then we will send this x to that side. So x plus 11, 132 minus x, and if this x is sent to that side, it is 132 x. Now when we multiply x into 132, that is 132 x, x into minus x, that is minus x square, 11 into 132, let it remain like that only, and 11 into minus x, that is minus 11x. This is all equal to 132 x. Now we can cancel out this 132x and this 132x on both sides. Now, if we change the signs for our convenience, x square plus 11x minus 11 times 132 is equal to 0. Now, we know the formula x is equal to minus b, that is minus 11, plus or minus square root of 11 square minus 4 into 11 a, that is 1, and then c, that is minus 11 into 132 whole by 2 into 1. So this will be minus 11 plus or minus square root of 121, and here if you multiply 4 into 11, 44 into 132 will give you 5808, this whole divided by 2. Now we have to add this 5808 and 121. Then we get minus 11 plus or minus square root of 5929 whole by 2. Now we have to find out the root for 5929. The root will give you 77. So minus 11 plus or minus 77 by 2. Of course, this minus 77, again, as it gives the negative value for speed of the train, therefore it can be discarded. And minus 11 plus 77, that is 66 by 2, therefore 33 km per hour is the speed of the passenger train. Now we know that the express train moves with 10 kilometers per hour faster. The express train moves 11 kilometers per hour. So express train speed, train average speed is 44 kilometer per hour. So in this you have to remember that the distance is same in both the two cases. If you do that, then automatically you will get the correct answers. Now let's do the last problem of this exercise, that is sum of the area of two squares is 468 meter square. If the difference of their perimeter is 24 meter, find the sides of the two squares. Let's consider one square with A side, the other square let it be with B side. Then its area is A square, perimeter is 4A, and here the area is B square and perimeter is 4B. That you all know. Now from the problem it's given, the difference in their perimeters is 24. So I took B as greater one, therefore 4B minus 4A is equal to 24. Therefore B minus A is equal to 6. I have divided throughout by 4. Therefore B is equal to A plus 6. The other information given in the problem is sum of the areas of two squares. So area means it's given that A square plus B square is equal to 468. Now in place of B square, let us substitute A plus 6 whole square, which should give us 468. Now when we simplify this, A square plus A square plus 12A plus 36 minus 468 is equal to 0. Now this is 2A square plus 12A minus 432. Because 468 and that is with negative and 36 with positive, so final figure will be minus 432. This can be divided throughout by 2. Therefore this equation is A square plus 6A minus 216 is equal to 0. Now again you can solve it either by formula method or by the factorization method. So here A is equal to minus B, that is minus 6 plus or minus square root of 36 minus 4 into 1 into minus 216 whole by 2A, 2 into 1, because A square quotient is 1. So here again minus 6, we have to take only positive value, because if the negative value is considered then A will be negative. So therefore we can neglect that negative value. Minus 6 plus 36, we have to calculate 4 times 216, that's going to be 864, and then this is with positive plus 36, then it is becoming 900. So 900 root is 30. So minus 6 plus 30 by 2, which gives us 30 minus 6, 24. So 12 meter is smaller square side. And then we know that B is equal to A plus 6. Therefore, we can say bigger B is equal to 12 plus 6, that is 18 meter. So these are the problems for 4.3. Now we will continue to solve the problems of 4.4. The very first problem, find the nature of the roots of the following quadratic equation. If the real roots exist, find them. So here, to know whether real roots exist or not, we have to check the discriminant. So B square minus 4AC is to be checked in all the problems. So here, when we talk about the first problem, so here A is equal to 2, B is equal to minus 3, and C is equal to plus 5. So B square minus 4AC is equal to minus 3 whole square minus 4 into 2 into 5, which is 9 minus 40, and turned out to be negative. So it does not have any real roots. Now let's talk about the second bit, that is this. A is equal to 3, B is equal to minus 4 root 3, C is equal to plus 4. Therefore, B square minus 4AC is equal to minus 4 root 3 whole square minus 4 into 3 into 4. This is going to be 48, because 4 square 16 into 3 48 minus 4 3s are 12, 12 4s are 48. So this will have equal and real roots as discriminant is equal to 0. Now what could be the real roots? So we know the formula x is equal to minus b plus or minus discriminant whole by 2a. Now here minus, as d is 0, x will be equal to minus b by 2a, that is minus of minus 4 root 3 by 2 times 3. So here this is going to be 4 root 3 by 2 into 3. So 2 2's are, so 2 root 3 by 3. Now let us talk about the third problem. The third problem is 2x square minus 6x plus 3 is equal to 0. So here again, A is equal to 2, B is equal to minus 6, C is equal to 3. Now B square minus 4AC. B square minus 4AC here is equal to minus 6 whole square minus 4 times A, 2 times, and then 3. So which is going to be 36 minus 24, which tells us it is 12 and it is positive quantity. Therefore, it will have real roots. Therefore, x is equal to minus b, that is minus of minus 6 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac, that's nothing but 12, we have already calculated, whole by 2 into 2, because here a is 2. Therefore, 6 plus or minus root 12 can be written as 4 into 3. So 2 root 3 by 4. If I take 2 as common, then 2 times 3 plus root 3, 3 plus or minus root 3 by 4. So 2 twos are, therefore the 2 roots will be, 1 is 3 plus root 3 by 2, the other one is 3 minus root 3 by 2. So these are the roots for this equation. In all these three problems, we have simply checked the discriminant. If discriminant is greater than 0, it will have real and different roots, distinct roots. If the discriminant is equal to 0, the two roots will be same. If the discriminant is less than 0, then it does not have any real roots. We have to check b square minus 4ac. So here a is equal to 2, this one, b is equal to minus 3, this, and c is equal to 5. Therefore, b square minus 4ac is equal to minus 3 whole square minus 4, 2 into 5, 4ac. So here, b square minus 4ac has turned out to be negative. Therefore, it does not have any real roots. The values of k, each of the following quadratic equation, so that they have two equal roots. Again, if it is to have equal roots, what's the condition? B square must be equal to 4ac, or b square minus 4ac must be equal to 0, which implies, of course, b square is equal to 4ac. Now, in the first question, a is equal to 2, b is equal to k, c is equal to 3. Now let us substitute here. B square, that is k square, must be equal to 4 into a, that is 2, into c, that is 3. So k square is equal to 12, or k is equal to root over 12. If the two roots are equal, then the condition is b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, or b square is equal to 4ac. Now let's find out the for the second one. Second one, we have to write in the form of quadratic equation. So kx into x, that is kx square, minus 2kx plus 6 is equal to 0. Now condition is b square must be equal to 4ac. Therefore, b square, that is 2k minus 2k whole square, is equal to 4 times a times c. Therefore, it's going to be 4k square minus, if you take that right side quantity to the left one, 24k is equal to 0. K, 4k is common, k minus 6 is equal to 0. Either k is equal to 0 or k is equal to 6. But here, if k is equal to 0, then this would no more be a quadratic equation. So the final answer is k is equal to 6. So the simple point in these two problems, we have to equate b square is equal to 4ac. Now let's talk about the third one. In this problem, is it possible to design a rectangular mango grove whose length is twice its breadth and the area is 800 meter square? If so, find its length and breadth. The first condition says length is twice the breadth. So length L is equal to twice the breadth. Okay, so this is our first equation. Now, its area is L into B, that is equal to 800. Area is L into B is equal to 800. This is our second equation. Now, by using these two equations, we must be able to find out whether a rectangle can be formed or not. So for that, if you replace B or L, suppose L is equal to 2B, that we will put here. So as L is equal to 2B, equation 2 can be written as 2B times B is equal to 800, or B square is equal to 400. This two goes to that side, then it divides 800. Therefore, B must be equal to plus or minus 20, because root over 400 is 20. But here we do not take negative value. Therefore, breadth is plus 20 only. Now, when breadth is 20 meter, because area is given in terms of meter square, then we know that L is equal to 2B. Therefore, you can say that 2 into 20, which is 40 meter. So, the answer, is it possible? The answer is yes. Then, what are the measurements? L is equal to, length is equal to 40 meter and breadth 20 meter. Now, if you verify the area, L into B, which is 800. So, all the conditions got satisfied. Now, let's do the fourth problem. What is fourth problem? Is the following situation possible? If so, determine their present ages. The sum of the ages of two friends is 20 years. 4 years ago, the product of that their ages is 48. So, let the present age of one person be X years. Then, age of second person is 20 minus X, because sum of their ages, present ages is 20. It's given from the problem. Now, 4 years ago, first person is X minus 4. Second person's is 20 minus X minus 4, which is 16 minus X. Now, the product was 48. Therefore, X minus 4 times 16 minus X is equal to 48. Now, X into 16, 16X. X into minus X square. 4 into 16, minus 64. Minus 4 into minus X, plus 4X. it is equal to 48. Now, if you send all these terms to this side, then it becomes x square. This 20x minus 20x, and then the 64 will be positive there. 48, 52 and 112. This will be equal to 0. Now let's check, what about b square minus 4ac? So minus 20 whole square minus of 4 into a1, this is 112. So it's going to be 400 minus 448, which is negative 48. As discriminant is negative, there cannot be real roots. Therefore, this event is not possible. So the final answer, no, it is not possible. This is the final answer. In all the problems, what we are doing, simply we are calculating the discriminant value. And based on that, we are telling the results. Next, this fifth problem. Is it possible to design a rectangular park of perimeter 80 and 400 meters area? So, perimeter. If you consider that the length of the rectangle is L and breadth of the rectangle is B, perimeter is nothing but 2 into L plus B, and that is given as 80. That means L plus B must be equal to 40. So let this be first equation. The area L into B is given as 400. This is our second equation. Now from the first equation, you can replace B as 40 minus L. From this equation, I can write B as 40 minus L. Now, 40L, I'm just multiplying it. And then L into L, L square is all equal to 400, or L square minus 40L, I'm shifting these left side terms to the right side, plus 400 is equal to 0. Now let us check again whether the discriminant is, what's the nature of the roots. So B square minus 4AC we have to check. So here this minus 40 whole square, B square, minus 4AC. So it's going to be 1600 minus 1600, which is equal to 0. When discriminant is 0, then the solution will be L is equal to minus B in this equation minus B by, because plus or minus this discriminant is 0, whole by 2 into 1. Therefore 40, as D is equal to 0, 40 by 2, which is 20, which gives me, as L plus B is equal to 40 and L is equal to 20, B should also be 20. So the solution set is 20, 20. We can say that a square is also a kind of rectangle. Therefore, it is possible to construct a rectangular park with the area 400 meter square and then perimeter 80 meter. So final answer is yes, it is possible. And this is the solution set. With that, we came to an end of this quadratic equation solutions. If you like the way the problems are solved, then you can subscribe my channel.